In this video, I will show you how to set the server preferences. The system preferences consist of server preferences and client preferences. In a network environment, also known as a client-server environment, there is a server and there are clients. These clients are connected to the server. Changes to the server preferences are global and will affect all the machines in the network, whereas changes in the client preferences are local and will only affect that particular machine. Even in a standalone environment where there is only one computer, you still have to set the server preferences and the client preferences. This is part one of our server preference video, and I will take you through the general settings. First, you must make sure you're signed in as administrator in order to set or make any of these changes. And then we need to open up our server preferences by going to your toolbar, click on File and Server Preferences. Across the top, you'll notice several tabs. We're going to start in the General tab right here. So below, you can see that we can set our default date range. Typically, this is the calendar year or even your fiscal year, so you can set that to whatever range you actually want, but we'll just leave it as the year. Over here, we have our custom footnote message that's going to be printed on all of your receipts, so you can obviously change that to anything that you want it to read. Now down where we have our default commission policies, this is a default that of the buy and the sell margin that will be set every time you want to create a new currency. This 4% will be applied, but obviously when you're in creating that new currency, you can set those buy and sell margins to whatever you want. This will just be your default. We also have default invoice behavior, so you'll want to put in a very popular currency that you will deal with, so that every time you open a new invoice, that will automatically populate. So we're going to leave ours as euros, and this will be for cash transactions. You can also add here your most used currencies. You can add up to two of those. And then down below, we can change the date display format, or set the date display format. So just select on the side, and you can choose from the drop-down. You can see that we can make it short, or we can keep it as the system date abbreviated. This date should be consistent with your operating system. Now we can put in our date entry format. So we can select from a range below. You'll notice that you can put in the range as such, or we can change that to read month, date, and then year. And now we can go and set our default phone format. So for the US, our standard, if we want, we just need to use the hashtag. And we can put dashes in. So that can be our set default phone format. Every time we type in a number, it will default into this format for us. Number of cash registers beside the main cash. So if you are a standalone business, you can leave that as zero, or if you have some other cash registers up front, we can change this to however many you have. Ask user to sign in with till before creating a new invoice. If you're a company that's dealing with cash, you'll probably want to assign this so that you know who's dealing all of your transactions. Whereas if you are a wholesaler or trading business, you might want to leave that unchecked because you're not always dealing with cash. Then we can activate our rule-based fee structures. You'll need to set your fee structures, and then in order to activate these on every transaction, we can apply those here. In another video, I will show you how to set those fee structures. And then we can also activate the rule-based AML policies. You'll want to check that if you want to be compliant. We can set our default language. I'll leave that at English. Stop filtering queries after however many matches. So for example, if your database is very large, in order to speed up any searches that you do, you can stop your filter and queries after, let's say, 50 matches. We can leave it at zero if you don't have much information inside the database already. That will bring up everything in your search. And then once you've set all of these, we can now save these settings, and they're going to be applied to your server. So then any client linked into the server are going to be affected as well. So you don't need to set each individual client preference to do this.